welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question, which says the mean and standard deviation of monthly salary in dollars are given below for factories A, B, and C. Find the combined mean and combined standard deviation. Before we move on to the solution, let's discuss the formula for the combined mean and combined standard deviation. First, we have the combined mean denoted by x bar is equal to n1 x1 bar plus n2 x2 bar, this whole upon n1 plus n2. Next, we have the formula for the combined standard deviation denoted by sigma or sigma 1, 2 when we have two series 1 and 2, and so this would be equal to square root of n1 into sigma 1 square plus t1 square the whole plus n2 into sigma 2 square plus d2 square the whole, and this whole upon n1 plus n2. This is the combined standard deviation, and here we have two series, series 1, where this n1 is the size of the series 1, x1 bar is the arithmetic mean of the series 1, sigma 1 is the standard deviation of series 1, and d1 is equal to x1 bar minus x bar, where this x bar is the combined mean. Then we have for the series 2, N2 is the size of the series, X2 bar is the arithmetic mean of the series, sigma 2 is the standard deviation of the series, and d2 is equal to x2 bar minus x bar. This is the key idea that we use for this question. Let's now proceed with the solution. We are given this table in which we have three factories A, B, and C, their respective number of employees, their average monthly salaries in dollars, and their respective standard deviations. And we are supposed to find the combined mean and combined standard deviation. Now, since we have three factories A, B, and C, this means we have three series. So, N1 would be the size of series 1, that is size of the factory A, which means that the number of employees in factory A, that is 50. So N1 is equal to 50. Then average monthly salary is the arithmetic mean. So X1 bar, which is the average monthly salary for factory A, and this is equal to 61. Sigma 1 is the standard deviation for the factory A, and this is 8. In the same way, N2 is the size of the factory B, that is the number of employees in factory B, which is 100. Then X2 bar is the average monthly salary for factory B, which is 70. And sigma 2 is the standard deviation for factory B, which is 9. Next, for factory C, N3 is 120, X3 bar is 80.5, and sigma 3 is 10. First of all, let's find out the combined mean denoted by x bar, and this would be equal to n1 x1 bar plus n2 x2 bar plus n3 x3 bar, and this whole upon n1 plus n2 plus n3. Let us now substitute the respective values. So we have x bar is equal to 50 into 61, that is n1 is 50, x1 bar is 61, plus n2 which is 100 into x2 bar, that is 70, plus n3 which is 120 into x3 bar which is 80.5, and this whole upon n1 plus n2 plus n3, that is 50 plus 100 plus 120. This is further equal to 50 into 61 is 3050 plus 100 into 70, 7000 plus 120 into 80.5, which is 9660, and this whole upon 270. This is equal to 19710 upon 270. 0 cancels with 0, and 9, 3 times is 27, and 657, 3 times is 1971, then 9, 73 times is 657. So we have x bar is equal to 73. That means the combined mean is 73. Next, we are supposed to find out the combined standard deviation denoted by sigma, and this would be equal to square root of n1 into sigma 1 square plus d1 square the whole plus n2 into sigma 2 square plus d2 square the whole plus n3 into sigma 3 square plus d3 square the whole, and this whole upon n1 plus n2 plus n3. Now we'll put the respective values in the formula for the combined standard deviation, that is sigma. Before that, let's find out d1, d2 and d3. D1 is equal to x1 bar minus x bar. X1 bar is 61 minus x bar which is 73. This is equal to minus 12. That is, we have D1 equal to minus 12. Then D2 is equal to x2 bar minus x bar which is equal to 70 minus 73, and that is equal to minus 3. So we have D2 equal to minus 3. Next is D3. This is equal to X3 bar minus X bar, which is equal to 80.5 minus 73. And this is equal to 7.5. That is, D3 is equal to 7.5. Now we put the values in the combined standard deviation formula. So we would have the combined standard deviation sigma is equal to square root of n1 into sigma 1 square plus d1 square the whole. Now the value of n1 from the table is 50. So 50 into sigma 1 square, that is 8 square, which is 64, plus d1 square, which would be minus 12 square, and that is 144, plus n2 2 into sigma 2 square plus d2 square the whole. The value of n2 is 100. So 100 into sigma 2 square, that is 9 square, which is 81, plus d2 square, and d2 is minus 3, so minus 3 square is 9, plus n3 into sigma 3 square plus d3 square the whole, and n3 is 120, so 120 into sigma 3 square, that is 10 square, which is 100, plus d3 square, that is 7.5 square, which becomes 56.25, and this whole upon n1 plus n2 plus n3, that is 50 plus 100 plus 120. So sigma is equal to square root of 50 into 208, that is 144 plus 64 is 208, plus 100 into 81 plus 9, which is 90, plus 120 into 156.25, and this will upon 270. This is further equal to square root of 10400, that is 50 into 208 is this, plus 100 into 90 is 9000, plus 120 into 156.25, which is 18750, and this whole upon 270, which is equal to square root of 38150 upon 270. The 0 cancels with 0. So we get square root of 3815 upon 27, which is equal to square root of 141.30, and this square root is equal to 11.89. That is, we get sigma is equal to 11.89, which is the combined standard deviation. Thus, finally we have combined mean given by x bar is equal to 73 and combined standard deviation given by sigma is equal to 11.89. So this is the final answer. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.